How do you feel about being nominated in so many categories tonight?
Oh, wow. No, as a film, we feel so privileged and honoured to be here, especially along the great list of nominees that are here. But just, you know, for myself to be nominated, you know, Will Poulter, I'm nominated against him, and Samantha Barks, you know, I'm such a huge fan of Will Poulter myself. So, you know, it's so honouring just to be with all these people that are here today, you know.
How important is this kind of recognition, particularly for independent cinema and films like yours?
No, it's very important, you know, because a lot of talent don't get acknowledged because of, you know, films being smaller and films not having the right, you know, advertisement, or just so many reasons when you get a low budget film. But it's so important here, especially because this film, there was so much young talent, and there's so many, not even just including me, you know, James Floyd, there's so many young actors in the film who deserve the credibility from, you know, the talent. And it's so important, especially for independent films like My Brother the Devil, to get the acknowledgement it deserves. So, you know, a lot of people get to see My Brother the Devil, because I'm not too sure a lot of people got to see it because of, you know, Twilight coming to the cinemas and Skyfall was out, but I'm sure the people that get to see it appreciate the film a lot.
The film has clearly had a massive impact on the critics and the fans who did get a chance to see it. Why do you think people responded so well to the film?
I think mainly because it's very touching, and a lot of people can relate to it. I mean, even though if you're not from the lifestyle that is set in, you know, you can... It's great because there's a lot of urban films these days that glamorize this world, and they don't really bring upon the subjects that are the topics that are discussed in this film, you know, sexuality and family, and, you know, there's so many things discussed in this film that bring a sense of sensitivity and vulnerability to the film, you know, and that's very important, which you don't get to see in a lot of urban films recently, you know, the family and what these people are actually really like in their house and their family, and, you know, so I think that was very important.
For anyone who hasn't been fortunate enough to see the film yet, can you just tell us a little bit about what the story is and how you fit into it and what excited you about playing that character?
Well, basically, it's a story that follows two young Egyptian brothers who live on a council estate. You know, it's very rough on a council estate, and it just follows their life on the course of a summer. And it's just basically the younger brother looks up to his older brother very much. You know, he's a drug dealer, he makes money, and in an estate, that's really great. So, you know, I look up to him and I want to prove to him that I'm a man, and he just sees me as a little brother. But, you know, he's done everything, but even he knows that this sort of lifestyle isn't for anyone that wants to, you know, get somewhere in life, you know. So he knows this isn't right for me, but for me, I just want to prove to my brother and all the gangs and the boys that, you know, that I'm a part of this. But, you know, it proves that this isn't the right path for anyone who lives that life, and anyone that's involved in gangs and etc. like that isn't the path for anyone that wants to pursue their career and anything, or want to have a life outside their estates, you know.
Clearly the relationship between these two brothers is such a pivotal centerpiece to the film. Can you talk a little bit on working on that, particularly with James?
Wow, that was amazing, actually. You know, working with James was brilliant. I did not, when I first met James, I met him as Rash. I didn't even know his name was James until like a couple of days in. You know, he was very method, and he was very annoying as well. You know, sometimes he'd come up to me and just slap me, you know, and I'm thinking, like, this is 3 days into working. I don't really know you well enough for you to slap me. And it's just, you know, a couple of days in, he'll slap me again. And then sometimes when I walk in, you know, when your brother walks into the room, you don't really anticipate. It's just like, yeah, whatever. And if a friend walks in, it's like, yeah, cool. But whenever I walk in, whenever I arrive on set, he'll just be like, cool, little man. Like, he didn't care about me. And he just built so much chemistry off set, which really helped the presence on screen, the chemistry between us on screen.
Of course, you're working with an astonishing talent behind the camera in Sally. I'm assuming she didn't slap you, but what kind of help did she...
Beating me up all the time. Sally was beating me up all the time, you know, but she was brilliant, you know. I can't really explain, because this is the first big director that I've actually worked with, but she was so brilliant. She was so brilliant in the way she would break stuff down to me and really explain to me and let me know where my character was before this scene and where he's going to be after and where he is, his current emotional state right now. And, you know, I've never worked with such a great director, but for me, she was the best director. Like, you know, the things that she would say to me and the actors before we would get together, and she would always tell me, you know, Fadi, less is more. And she'll bring me to the side and let me watch a playback and just be like, look, this is what I didn't like, less is more, bring it down, stop acting. And she's like, no, seriously, less is more, stop acting. And then, you know, she gave me the freedom with the script as well. It was just, you know, even though there was a script, it was just a basic script, and, you know, you could improvise. I'll say, Sally, I didn't really like this. This isn't how my character would say it. And she would be like, change it. How would your character say it? And she just gave us the freedom to really play with the script, which really helped and, you know, took a lot of pressure off us.
We do hope that you are going to keep acting, despite what Sally would see. Do you know what you're doing next? Have you got anything on the...
Well, I've got a few. I've just recently signed with my agency, Troika, Gary at Troika, and he's been doing great things for me. And, you know, hopefully we can keep up the work rate. But I've managed to get a role in Doctor Who, which airs in the summer, and also Casualty, and World War Z, starring Brad Pitt, which comes out this year as well.
clearly World War Z, much anticipated based on the best-selling book. Can you talk a little bit, who do you play in?
I just play, it's a really small role. I play a Palestinian son on a bus. But it was actually World War Z that inspired me to start acting, because I remember the director, Mark Foster, and he directs Brad Pitt, and I was just like, wow. When we were filming in Malta, there was like 600 extras, and it was just a huge set, and I was just really like, you know, I'd done the scene, and director Mark Foster was like to me, listen, you're amazing, like, carry on acting, just, you're going to go really far. And for him to say that, I was just like, this guy directs Brad Pitt, like, he's telling me that. So that's when I realized, okay, so maybe I do have a talent in acting, and that's when I really continued to pursue it. So
obviously we've seen the initial trailer for World War Z. I mean, the scale of it and the action seems to go even beyond what's in the book. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, no, it's such a huge budget film. I remember being there, and it was just like, I was only there for a week, so I didn't really get to see that much, but you know, just being there was like two or three helicopters filming, and just so many units of set and so many extras, 600 extras a day standing in the sun, and it was just such a huge production. And I can imagine, it was just so great. I can't wait to see the film, because I only got to see a bit of it, like, you know.
Pleasure to talk to you tonight. Last question before you go. Doctor Who, good guy or bad guy?
Weird guy, alien.